Today, inshallah, we will talk about shock in children. My voice is clear?
Yes, it's clear, Dr. Muhammad.
Yeah, okay. All of us know that shock is very big topic and a lot of details found in the shock. Today, we will focus only on brief practical points during management of shock the patient. So today I'll start my presentation with this case, 2 years old, previously healthy female, presents with 3 days of fever and decreased activity, temperature 39.6, heart rate 180, blood pressure 70 above 30, respiratory rate 40, oxygen saturation 90 on room air, extremities cold, clammy, pulses are weak, capillary fill time 4 seconds. Patient appear lethargic with poor response to nexus stimuli. If we can make it interactive, so what is the abnormal data in our patient here?
Dr. Muhammad, you can see the chat for the answers, or should I tell you what's written there?
I'll try to open it 1 second.
You just go for the panel there and you look for chat.
Okay.
Or view options and you look for chat.
1 second. Yes. So, low blood pressure, it's okay. Septic shock, this is the final diagnosis of the patient. Okay. Fever, tachypnea. All data, yes. Actually, all finding in this patient are abnormal. Patient is febrile, tachypneic, tachycardic, hypotensive, desaturated, poor pulse, poor capillary fill time, poor neurological state. So what is the next step? You saw this patient in your clinic. What is the first step you will do for this patient? ABC, it's okay. Airway, breathing, circulation, nice. But in practical issue, what is the first step I'll do? Normal saline, IV fluid, IV fluid. IV line, excellent. So the first step I'll do to insert peripheral line. To give 100% oxygen. Now saturation became 94, and this is accepted of, for us. Second step, I'll try to get peripheral line, but unfortunately, peripheral line was so difficult after 3 trials of insertion. So what is the next step? IO access, excellent. I can see the chat, so I answer from the chat. I read the answer that you write on the chat. So IO, okay, excellent. So intraosseous access was inserted, and the blood glucose, blood investigation taken. What is the next step? Shock saline, excellent. How many ml saline, and over how many minutes I'll give the saline? Excellent, 20 ml per kg. So first bolus of saline, 20 ml per kg given. I try to check the capillary fill time, the pulse, the perfusion, the heart rate, and there is mild improvement, but still abnormal. So what is the next step? To give another bolus saline. The same condition improvement, what is the next step? To give the third bolus saline. So up to 40 to 60 ml per kg saline we can give. for on how many minutes? 5 to 10 minutes. In treatment of shock patient, we must give very fast, either by rapid infusion or manual by the hand. So 60 ml saline rapidly infused. However, vital sign still the same. What is the next step? Dr. Mahmoud Musa, inotropes. Dr. Asma, inotropes. Dr. Rah, inotropes. Adrenaline. Okay, excellent. So we will start epinephrine. And why epinephrine, we will tell later. 0.1 mic per kg per minute. What is the next step? There is very important step. Most of us forget when deal with shock patient. You will find this patient and this situation and you are alone, and most of us forget this. Yes, as Dr. Lamia, Dr. Magid, Dr. Muhammad Aimer, antibiotic. So antibiotic is very, very important to give during the first hour, broad spectrum antibiotic. So broad spectrum antibiotic started, then patient admitted to the ICU, then management continued at the ICU center line, and the arterial line was placed, were placed. Epinephrine dose increased to 0.3. Still there is minimal improvement and patient not well yet. Blood pressure became 80 above 32. So norepinephrine was added, 0.1 mg per kg per minute. And after that, hydrocortisone stress dose started. So this case summarizes what will I talk today. There is some definition. Sorry. The shock. Shock is a condition characterized by significant reduction of tissue perfusion, resulting in decreased tissue oxygen delivery. There is other definition you will hear to it, and it must be familiar to us. First one is compensated shock. Compensated shock, from the words itself, the body try to compensate the diminished perfusion and make the systolic blood pressure maintained on normal range by tachycardia, by peripheral vasoconstriction. So you will find the peripheral pulsation may be weak. You will find the skin cold and the motile. Second, the term is hypotensive shock. At this stage, body compensatory mechanisms are overwhelmed. So you will find the heart rate in this situation is markedly elevated, and at this stage also hypotension will develop. Last stage, and we hope not to happen when we deal with shock depression, is irreversible shock. You will find the bradycardia, you will find the blood pressure very low, and irreversible organ damage will happen, and unfortunately this at the last. The message of this, I know this is something theoretical, but the message from this slide, just keep in mind that patient may be shocked, but not hypotensive. Most of us link between shock and hypotensive. If patient not hypotensive, so he is not in shock. This is not true. You can find patient normal, has normal blood pressure and in shock. And this stage we call that compensated shock. So your role at this time to manage hardly the situation, trying not to get hypotensive shock or finally the irreversible shock. Classification, and this is known for all of us, hypovolemic shock, distributive shock, which includes septic and anaphylactic neurogenic shock, and third one, cardiogenic shock, and the last, obstructive shock. I'll not go in details for both physiology or shock as this theoretical, but in brief, this hypovolemic shock, there is decreased volume in the circulation. So we expect when we give volume expander, the condition of hypovolemic shock will improve. Second one, the cardiogenic shock, here the problem in the heart itself. There is pump failure. So we expect when we give medication that make the heart contract strongly, the condition of the shock will improve. In the obstructive shock, we can find something obstruct the flow, like cardiac tamponade, like tension pneumothorax, like pulmonary embolism. So when we treat the cause, the condition of the shock will improve. And finally, the distributive shock, there is problem in systemic peripheral resistance. So, and the abnormal distribution of the fluid in the microcirculation. So when we give, also sometimes the heart may be affected because of toxin of the septicemia. So when we give medications that control the peripheral resistance and augment the action of the heart, we expect the condition of the shock in this situation will improve. Common features of shock, like we saw in our case, you will find patient tachycardic, skin cold, clammy, pale, mottled, capillary fill time more than 2 seconds. All of us, the normal capillary fill time is less than 2 seconds. Sometimes capillary fill time may be flash, mean when you breathe, immediately it's refilled. Less than 1 second, sometimes it's present of the some cases of the shock. You will find patient drowsy, lethargic, also sometimes oligoric. For peripheral pulsation, it will be weak in comparison with central pulses. Also sometimes the pulses may be bounding. Lactic acidosis and late hypotension. There is 5 questions. If we answer this question, we will identify the cause of the shock. The previous feature tell us that patient in shock. So what is the cause of the shock? First question, if there is a history of trauma. Second question, any fluid loss. Third question, any fever, hypothermia. Fourth one, any exposure to allergen, and the fourth one is abnormal cardiac exam, and the last one, exposure to allergen. So if there is history of trauma, so we expect that we deal with hemorrhagic shock, obstructive shock, pneumothorax, or cardiogenic shock due to direct trauma to the heart. If there is history of fluid loss, so mostly we deal with hypovolemic shock, which may be due to gastroenteritis, due to DKA, due to polyuria. If there is fever, so mostly we deal with septic shock. If there is abnormal cardiac exam, so mostly we deal with cardiogenic shock. And last, if we there is history of exposure to allergen, so this is mostly anaphylactic shock. So this simple diagram helps us to identify the cause of the shock. The septic shock, initial resuscitation, like we did in our case, but this to revise again. First hour, it's very, very important. When I was in my residency, my senior told me, I'll tell in Arabic, مهم جدا تسبق السبسيس بخطوة. اوعى السبسيس تسبقك. لو السبسيس سرقك او السبتك شوك سرقتك العين ضاع منك. يعني كان دايما يقول لي كده ان عربك يعني. So first hour it's very very important. Even by minutes it's important. So first time, first 5 minutes it's mandatory to obtain vascular access. IV, peripheral IV line or intraosseous line. So common mistake you will find. You will find sister try or doctor try to insert peripheral line for half an hour. This is not accepted. Peripheral line, if not got it within 5 minutes, immediately go to intraosseous. It's very important to start fluid resuscitation within 30 minutes. It's very important to give broad spectrum antibiotic during first 60 minutes. And for patient with not responding to fluid, that's called fluid refractory shock, we must start peripheral or central anaerobic support. So first 5 minutes access, first 30 minutes fluid, first 60 minutes antibiotic, first 60 minutes anaerobic support. This our ABC airway breathing, 100% oxygen. Our targeted oxygen target saturation not more than 97. If airway not maintained, we can go for rapid sequence intubation. Again, rapid IV IO access, fluid resuscitation 10 to 20 ml per kg per bolus, normal saline or Ringer lactate we can give over 5 to 10 minutes. This must be given during the first hour. And it's very, very important to observe what happened to the patient with each step of management. Now I give now 20 ml per kg saline. So I must check again capillary fill time, I must check pulse, heart rate, urine output, blood lactate. So it's very, very important with each step to notice patient improve or deteriorate. If still not improving, so means that patient need more action, so I'll go to next step. If patient deteriorate, so there is something to be considered, I'll tell later. All of us heard about cold septic shock and warm septic shock. And this was past terms. Nowadays, no more septic shock, no more cold septic shock, no more warm septic shock. And also, there was thought that dopamine was the first line when we deal with shocked patient. Nowadays, epinephrine, norepinephrine is the first option, and any one of them, no priority for one of them on the other. There is recent guideline 3 months or 4 months back about the shock, and this guidelines from it. So no more cold, no more warm, and first choice for inotropes is adrenaline or noradrenaline, any one of them with no superiority for anyone on the other. On the catecholamine resistant shock, we will give stress dose hydrocortisone 2 to 4 mg per kg. This is common used inotropes, first one epinephrine, and this is the most common use, as I told, used in septic shock, anaphylactic shock, and also, as we know, from pulse in systolic arrest. It can cause renal splanchnic vessel constriction, cause also tachyarrhythmia and hyperglycemia. Second one, norepinephrine, it can use alone on septic shock, or it can use with epinephrine. It causes bradycardia and reducing tissue perfusion. Third one, dopamine used in septic shock only when epinephrine and norepinephrine not available. You are in casualty and no epinephrine, norepinephrine available, and you want to start inotrope, you will start dopamine. This only the situation for the dopamine. So dopamine now on the third step, not in the first like we saw before. Dopamine, it causes the tachyarrhythmia and pulmonary vascular vasoconstriction. It can use peripherally or centrally. Actually, all this inotropic support, it can use central, mean by central line, or peripheral, by peripheral line on low dose. And this is to be restricted in narrow situation. Not all patient we will give epinephrine or norepinephrine in peripheral line, but now you are in casualty and this patient need inotropes, we can start in one of them according to two guidelines with a small dose till patient admitted and stabilized at BICU, central line inserted. At this time, we can increase the dose if we need and shift the inotrope from peripheral line to central line. This is less commonly used inotrope, used in special circumstances like dobutamine, used in cardiogenic shock. It causes tachyarrhythmia, hypotension, because of peripheral vasodilatation. Second one is merinone, used in cardiogenic shock after cardiac surgery. It causes arrhythmia, hypotension, and thrombocytopenia. And the last one, vasopressin, it can cause also in septic shock, which require high dose of catecholamine. It causes splanchnic peripheral ischemia due to severe vasoconstriction. What is the lab we need to do with patient with sepsis and septic shock? Actually, all investigation we can send, but there is something please not to miss. rapid blood glucose, CBC with differential, RFT, LFT, DIC profile, urine analysis, culture. Culture, it's very, very important to send all culture available, blood culture, urine culture, if patient intubated, ATT culture, inflammatory marker also, it's important, CRP and BCT, blood gas, blood lactate, it's very, very important as it's a trend, guided us if patient improved or not. Serum electrolyte, coagulation profile, and as I told, the culture. When we stop the management of the shock, patient was shocked, and I do all the steps as I explained. So when I stop, when we find the quality of central and the peripheral pulse is the same. Both are strong and equal. When we find the skin perfusion or capillary fill time less than 2 seconds, patient has normal conscious level. Urine output more than 1 mL/kg/h, blood pressure on normal range, and simply to remember if patient hypotensive or not, you will know this 60, 70, and equation. 60, any new need, his systolic blood pressure less than 60 is hypotensive. First year, if blood pressure, systolic blood pressure less than 70 is hypotensive. And after 1 year, we will use this equation. We will multiply age by 2 and add 70. If less than this number, the patient will be hypotensive. If we give example like patient is 5 years old, so 2 by 5, it will be 10, plus 70, it will be 80. So if we find systolic blood pressure less than 80, so this patient is hypotensive. This is rapid to recognize the lowest accepted blood pressure instead of going to this long chart during this critical time. And finally, also if serum lactate less than 2. So this is the therapeutic end point of shock. Second type of shock is hypovolemic shock. And as before, airway breathing circulation will give oxygen, will establish IV access, will give fluid bolus 20 ml/kg over 5 to 10 minutes from saline or Ringer lactate. And it's very important to observe for overload time. You must check for the heart, for galvanism, for the chest, for basal crepitation, and for the liver, for hepatomegaly. This is 3 points. It's very important after giving the fluid. In case of refractory shock, means that the patient will give fluid to him, and there is no improvement. So you must evaluate for ongoing blood loss and other causes of shock. It's very important to correct hypoglycemia and any electrolyte imbalance when you deal with hypovolemic shock. Like most of us see this, if patient came with gastroenteritis and the hypovolemic shock, you will correct the hypovolemia, and you will find also sometimes hyponatremia, hypernatremia, hypokalemia. So this electrolyte disturbance you must correct. Finally, the point that we want to remember all the time, if patient in pure hypovolemic shock, so no role for inotropes. It's not accepted that patient in hypovolemic shock and we find him on adrenaline or noradrenaline or dopamine. This is not accepted. But in this situation, if we find hypovolemic patient need inotropic support, mean not improve after multiple boluses of IV fluid, and you know, blood loss, and you find that patient need inotrope, so mostly there is something else with the hypovolemic shock. Maybe hypovolemic shock with septic shock. This may happen, so at this time, it's okay to give inotropic support. The last slide. This is some mistakes we can do when we manage a case of shock. First one, as I told now, it's if peripheral line is difficult, please don't waste time in multiple trials. And in BICU setting, if patient still not stable, please not to go to insert central line immediately and still patient on shock state. Just insert intraosseous manage the patient. When patient stabilized, go for center line. Second one, it's very important to recognize non-specific sign of compensated shock, like tachycardia. You will find the patient tachycardic, please check. It will be discussed later with Dr. Mahmoud if you find symptom like this, sign like this. But for you, check if patient is okay, how is the hair perfusion, how is his conscious level, how is urine output. So it's very important to recognize this, and if patient in shock state, start the management immediately. Third one, it's important to give appropriate volume during fluid resuscitation. If patient in septic shock, it's not accepted to give one bolus and still patient not improving, and you tell, okay, I give bolus saline. No, this is not enough. You can give second bolus and observe. You can give third bolus and observe if patient is improving or not. Also, in patient with cardiogenic shock, and this is a special situation of the shock. As I told during the vasophysiology, the problem is heart pump failure. So you want to give something to augment the action of the heart, not to overload the body with fluid. So the amount of fluid that accepted to be given during cardiogenic shock is 5 to 10 ml only, 5 to 10 ml per kg over 10 to 15 minutes. And observe after that if patient improve or not. If not improving, start anatropic support immediately. And as I told, the first choice in cardiogenic shock is dobutamine. Finally, it's important to monitor the response for each step of the treatment. This is, in brief, some idea about the shock. And if there is any question, I'll answer. Thank you.